As it turns out, the efficiency of quicksort is actually pretty complicated. First, let's just focus on the worst case. What would that look like? The magic of this algorithm is that it cuts the number of comparisons you need to do by splitting the array in half pretty much every time. So the worst case for us would be if we couldn't split the array in half and had to do all of the comparisons every time. You'll end up doing all of the comparisons if the pivots are actually already in the right place. Since 13 is already the biggest element, we'll end up comparing it to everything else on the first go and realizing that it doesn't need to move. This is a lot of comparisons to do at once. But the real problem happens when the next value is also the largest. Again, we end up comparing to everything smaller than it, and we're not saving any steps. Hopefully, the number of comparisons here reminds you of bubble sort. Remember, in bubble sort, we would have to compare each element to the one next to it, again and again and again and again. Eventually, we could leave off the ones that were at the end because we knew they were in the right place. The worst case of quicksort is exactly the same, which means that the worst case of quicksort is actually big O of n squared, for something called quicksort, that's a really terrible efficiency. However, quicksort is useful for two main reasons. First of all, the average and best case complexity are actually n log n. In a good case, the pivot will move down to the middle, and we'll get to divide the array in half every time. With our pivot in the middle, we can look at the other halves of the array and move their pivots to the middle too. Since these pivots are sorted, we know that everything else is sorted. So we're done really quickly. Here, because we're cutting the array in half every time, it'll end up looking a lot like merge sort. So again, that's why our efficiency is n log n. The average case is actually going to look a lot like this. We'll pick a random number, it'll move close to the middle, and so on and so on. However, if we know we're going to be getting arrays that are near sorted, we don't want to use quicksort, since that'll end up being the worst case every time. The second point is that you can do some optimizations with quicksort that'll make it run faster. For example, when you split your array, you can configure your program such that it runs both halves at the same time. It'll end up using the same amount of computing power, but it'll eat up less time. Also, rather than selecting the last element as a pivot, you could look at the last few elements and select the median of them as the pivot. Selecting the median will give you a better sense of what's in the middle of the array overall, so you have a better chance of moving your element in the middle and having that best case scenario. Also, this version of quicksort is in place, so we aren't using any extra space. Our space complexity is constant.